are Nigerians in need of liberation. Yes, but liberation from the world is very important. You know, are Nigerians in need of liberation? Yes. Liberation from what? What are Nigerians willing to liberate themselves from? You know, this is an important question nobody can really ask. You know, everybody act like Nigerian people are cowards. Like this fellow called me because I don't do this police for shine. So Facebook say me I'm a coward. The issue about cowardice in liberation, say that issue of seeing Nigerian people with fear to die or putting the fear to die for. Well, me as a Lagosian, I know say the moment I step out of my house in Lagos, my chances of dying immediately increase by about 80%. I'm not doing liberation, I'm not doing struggle. But I must hustle. I mean, we must walk, we must eat.
Yeah.
In the process of this, millions of Nigerians die every day.
Yes.
It never stopped any Nigerian from hustling. We are still willing to go out there and risk our life. Risk our life for container falling from bridge on your head and killing you. Area boy beating you up and robbing you, police shooting you, tanker exploding on express and roasting you and your family inside your car, building collapsing on you. Anything can happen. Avoidable death. We are not even talking about you were sick. Because many people could tell you say they're not in struggle because they're sick. Call that same person say you chance they to make 50,000 somewhere. It will show with a sickness. We die here. So I understand that the value system of Nigerian people need to first of all liberate from. We must liberate from our value system. Those things that we believe are worth our lives. That is what we must liberate ourselves from before we can now fully begin to engage with struggle. Many of us believe the lies of our oppressor. Our comrade here talk about oppressors in waiting. She said many Nigerians here, you know, being oppressed are oppressors in waiting. It's true, but why? Why is it easier for us to want to be oppressors than liberators? Might not say it is easy to oppress. It is because we are all educated by our oppressors. The curriculum of every educational system in every country is created by the oppressor. If you read Paulo Freire's Pedagogy of the Oppressed, it goes into it very deeply how your education prepares you to be an oppressor in waiting. And why? Because in your educational system, your oppressor will be example of society. That's why everybody here wants to be like Dangote. Even if Dangote is the reason why you are homeless. The price Dangote sells is cement is the reason why young people in Nigeria cannot be homeowners. Is the reason why the federal government of Nigeria cannot embark on massive public housing or public housing programs. But Nigerian elites, Nigerian influencers, celebrities, movie makers, everybody you look up to, newsmakers, everybody will tell you Dangote is positive to the society. So education is one of the biggest tools for our person. The more educated you are, the more difficult it is for you to be a liberator. I never see any liberator engaged. In my family, only my uncle, one of our uncle was a professor. And I ain't one for military college. We kill his grandmother. That is what PhD does for you. Help you rationalize your decision. You forget say nobody can ever rationalize a good thing. The Western idea for rationalization is because their value system is based on people. So when you make back against a man, you go and bomb his country, you kill him, you destroy his way of life, you must begin to rationalize it. I did it because I want to make him a Christian to say so. I did it because I want to teach him democracy to say this now. So the first thing as liberator, what you must do is to liberate yourself from your value system. You see me now, when I was growing up, I say if I never get $150 million, I don't go born. That's what I tell myself. Because why? My value system too was tied to the value system of my oppressor. Well, no oppressor can respect a black man doesn't have money or some kind of success. So yeah, let me get some money so that everybody can respect me. When we talk of education of the people, of the masses, in struggle. When the masses in struggle, struggle not get masses from Nigeria. ENSAS, success, ENSAS and protest, no. ENSAS now, all of you are going to show that you love celebrities as usual. The only reason ENSAS was a success was because all your favorite celebrities are here. Finish. Because if not, what is happening now? They don't quiet all the celebrities. Does that mean what you went out for has changed? But if no celebrity, no influencer has come out to tell you, go and protest tomorrow. Yeah. Everybody on this lady can say it 1 million times and nobody will come. So we give too much credit to these so-called leads. Everybody here is a leader of the struggle. The struggle for Nigeria's liberation is not big enough to have rank and file. If you are here thinking you are a rank and file member of liberation, just go home now because you are still lost. If you are sitting down here today, it means you are a leader of our liberation movement. You are not a leader. You are not enough. So it is the responsibility of leadership. You are not here because you are a follower of Fukunye. No, you are here because you are a follower of the idea to represent to promote, right? Yes. So, is that idea already in society the way it should be?
No.
Why should we contest? I criticize all these ones. That's why they don't like me. What is the effect? They are psychopaths around me. I criticize all of them. I say, what are you all doing around here? You should be in your communities. Everybody is around because if you win, they want posts. They want to be minister of culture, minister of petroleum. So instead of doing the work, everybody is around us, down to that. When you liberate, you are in your community doing the work. We all here have to be in our communities doing the work, enlightening ourselves, reading daily. Because if you decide to engage in struggle at this level in Nigeria, you are engaging in the vanguard. The idea of liberation never permeates society. Ritual you could not say, hey, so Sore is doing this. Komekolape is doing this. Jaff are doing it. No. That's why we continue to take 2 steps forward and 10 steps back all the time. So for me, the question about whether Nigerians need to be liberated is important. But what it doesn't ask, what are we liberating ourselves for? Yes. Because the thing that is holding us back really is our inability to cast away the value system of our oppression. We have been educated in it, we believe in it so much that it's difficult for us to let it go. It's difficult. I understand it too. Sometimes I go on the bed for my house. When I go see some of my friends, it's spend some time bar. When I say I can get access to that bar, I've got a struggle. I say, no, I'm not going. I'll go see what they come up from the place. I'll bed some time for. Now, the level where they understand, see, those are my sacrifices for the liberation of my people, and it is worth it. My father could have been the richest musician in the world, not only Africa. Father could have been the richest musician in the world. I'll tell you a story you don't know today. It was a head-to-head race between Fela and Boman. They came to Fela, came down the lyrics. Reduce your songs to 5 minutes. Forget to sing about love. If you hear one of Fela's interview for one documentary, he talks, African music cannot be about love. African music must be about revolution. He had just finished a meeting the week before, or like a month before, with his black boy for Panama Records. When Fela refused, that's why they went to God. And that's why Bonnie Wheeler and Peter Tosh left Bob, because Bob agreed. After that, giving us, to you be love. I'm giving her freely to the beside my daughter. It was the biggest artist in the world. Maybe millions of dollars. While immediately the imperialist forces turned on Bella, reduced him to nothing. My father was begging to keep her. They finished burning his house. My father didn't used to keep money in the bank. All the money was in his house. They reduced him to a beggar. My father, he was going to his beggar to beg for money. Before his talent raised him up again. Then they took him to jail. He had to take the boy again. So, you have to be willing to give up from certain values. Without your ability to detach yourself from those values, it is easy for the oppressor, right, to make you an oppressor. It is easier for that spirit of the oppressor in waiting inside you to be awakened. And what is the strongest way to resist this? What I'm coming here to talk about, and the second question we are going to talk about, is the practical steps. I don't think there are steps. I think there's one practical step. The step of solidarity. So, the understanding of solidarity among the left in Nigeria is what? I truly don't believe that we understand solidarity to mean we all believe in the same thing and we are committed to achieving the same thing. Now, the methods might be different on upon water, as the Bible always says. But the fact that our methods are different, does that mean that we are in opposition?